Before we begin, let me start by saying, you may ask me, Jeb, why are you so bitter? Well, it's because we all done seen all this shit over and over again, and every damn one of them turns out to be the same cow pie. I don't hate it because it's cool to hate it. I hate it because it's a fucking cow pie. The stars, and I use this term loosely, of our movie today are Charlie Chaplin, Geoffrey Chaucer, Steph Kick-Ass, the superhero that even Marvel fans know is whacker than Whitney Houston's crack. Too soon. Hey, one superhero per comic book universe, Johnny Storm. It's okay if I'm old because I don't have to do nothing action-y. James T. Kirk's father. Oh, no. Just f***ing no. Can we just roll this dollop of duty? Our story begins with some flashy comic booky looking sh** because Marvel frontin' like most of the people watching this movie read or have ever even held a real comic book. But our story really begins with these two twins getting a little too lovey-dovey, but I guess we ain't supposed to know they're twins, which makes this scene almost as gross as Leia kissing Luke. Almost. So anyway, some guy said over the loudspeaker that they being attacked, and we see that outside in some CGI snow, some CGI superheroes are flying around looking super cheesy. Look at this scene and tell me, why is this considered cool and the Power Rangers corny? Because if you ask me, except for the rainbow colored tights, Power Rangers look about as smooth as this shit right here. So Captain America throws his bike and makes this lame fucking joke like, it just slipped out. That's what she said. Scarlet, have you ever thought you might be more efficient if you went into battle without your tits hanging out? We see that they're at the Hydra Research Base in Sokovia, Eastern Europe, see how it says right there, which isn't even a real fucking country. Dude, it's not the fucking 1920s, you don't need a fucking monocle. All this fucking made up technology and nobody in your made up Sokovia can just give your ass one contact lens. I think he's just sophisticated frontin'. Meanwhile, Fiona over here trying to calm down Shrek because she like that big green I hope she is prepared for him hulking out every fucking morning after they get married when he sees her without her makeup on. And it's a good thing his pants expand every time he grows because otherwise his dick be flopping out. Junior Charlie Chaplin would be so ashamed. You play him, then you go and do this shit and ruin any ounce of credibility you could have possibly had. Charlie would laugh at your career. Silently. So Tony, how about you don't walk around like a cocky dick? Or a dicky c**k, whichever you feel best describes you. You're alone, you're in enemy territory, you ain't got no superpowers without your suit, your ass is grass, homie. So this shit goes on forever and it's boring and I'm already wondering why they ain't named this movie Age of Dultron. And to make a long story short, Loogie's scepter from one of them other 82 movies is in there, and the Revengers trying to get it back from this guy named Von Sucker, and Tony encounters new and improved Kick-Ass, aka Fit Boy and his sister Hit Girl. And for a minute it looks like they all dead, and I am thrilled with this imagery. We only 12 minutes into this pile of piglet pellets and they already promoting Infinity War. So whatever, Tony gets the scepter. So Tony wants to use this SMRT space rock stone brain to create his AI wet dream called Ultron because Jarvis is too small to satisfy him. And he wants to use Ultron to save the world from dumbass humans much like himself. Because apparently he didn't see the teaser trailer or Terminator or any other fucking movie about AI and don't know Ultron is going to be fucking evil. All this behind the backs of all the other Avengers except Bruce Banner because Bruce wants tan lines around the edges of his stretchy blue shorts. Look, Bruce gonna keep it on the down low because he just wanted to chill and not be a big rage monster for a while. Because the only thing worse than blue balls is green ones. So, create AI, try to get AI to explain to other AI that his job is to protect humans. Then the bad AI realized that humans ain't worth a f***, which we knew that, but you know, we ain't f***ing AI, we can't control the whole damn planet. And then bad AI take over the good AI to wipe out the humans. I'm assuming. Sound like a f***ing plan to me, let's go. And now here is a rare behind the scenes audio clip of my raw recordings of me watching this movie. This is for real, y'all. This is my raw material, no bullshit. Forgive my partner in crime in the background and her obnoxious laughter. Play that sh**. Oh, where's the Stan Lee cameo? Is it coming? Is it coming? I got a feeling that old fart is gonna pop in at any moment. No! How'd I fucking call it? And he says Excelsior. Okay, enough of that. Back to the plot explanation. Kinda. Time to crash the party. Kill them, Ultron. Kill them all. Oh, he look a little crusty. Is he about to break out into the thrill dance? So essentially, Ultron attacks the Avengers and Tony realizes he probably f***ed up. The parties always end like this. Could you all stop falling into each other's cleavage and f***ing fight? Oh my God, that was terrible. Did you see that shit? Oh my Lord. I'm gonna sound like a broken record this whole f***ing video because it just, okay. So should I be persecuted for sounding like a broken record for saying this CGI shit and all there is titties when all they do is show a bunch of shit and a bunch of titties? I don't think that's fair. And then Ultron tells the Avengers that they are the biggest threat to this planet? Have you taken a f***ing look around? There's a lot of shit that could go. So because I've wasted a bunch of time, let me summarize. They destroyed him, but he and AI and they're f***ing everywhere, so he's already rebuilding his ass. Plus, he's accessed all their files, so he's seen their d*** pics, I know that. And he also has access to the nuclear codes. We have made up shit in a comic book universe. Motherfuckers flying in suits, other motherfuckers turning green and smashing shit, another motherfucker flexing his muscles and flinging his hammer and stealing all the because that's the most dangerous thing. And this other mother, well, I ain't gonna worry about Captain America, he ain't been late since the 1940s, and nuclear codes are still the biggest problem. I mean, at least the new Star Trek movie, at least the new Star Trek movie had Spock using some type of matter that could be shot into the center of a planet and suck the motherfucker into a black hole. We can't have something like that. Nuclear codes. Okay, play again. Why does this movie suck so bad? Why is there so much money in it? Why do people keep going? Why? Is it because it's all that's there? If you'd stop going for a while, people would make different movies. I didn't even pay to rent this bitch. I checked it out from the public library. Is it that y'all are trying to score brownie points with your dumb hipster friends? Do y'all even know what y'all like? Have you lived long enough and been away from people long enough, and that includes the internets, to develop your own identity and realize what you really like? And once you found what you really like, did you go back to your dumb friends and have them say, "That's stupid," and you change your preference again? Is individuality an endangered concept? Which brings me back to my first point. Kill them, Ultron! But it doesn't. And oh, do I sense dissension amongst the ranks? So Ultron rebuilds his body, recruits the Molotov twins, and builds an army. Also, this AI is dumb as shit, but trying to be deep. And the fact that he made himself so fucking huge tells me that he has some major junk issues. Okay, so quick little question. Why does this dumb as shit AI, who's trying to be deep, want to recruit humans to take out other humans when he just said that his greatest asset is that he controls all of his bodies under one mind? Why would he want to bring these uncontrollable factors into the equation? Doesn't make much fucking sense to me, but since I know that they're gonna become Avengers, I'm just gonna guess that that's why. And don't say it's cause he's lonely. I don't think he's lonely. I think he's a pompous dick. I think he likes himself a lot. And I think he'd be perfectly fine if he could just build another one of himself and get married to it in Las Vegas at the Hunka Hunka Burning Love All Night Wedding Chapel with a fat Elvis impersonator as a witness. I'm supposed to be explaining this movie to y'all who would never watch it, and I'm sorry, but I just, oh my God, I'm failing you all. I've ended up just bitching about the people who love it and going hoarse. That's more fun. Let's do more of that. So we head over to a salvage yard, see how it says it right there, where we meet Gollum, who has vibranium, the strongest metal in the world, because it's made up, but Avengers to the rescue, and Ultron tells a little joke, and Tony says, "Beat me by 1 second." Yeah, well, the AI be doing that to everybody, so I hear. Pretty soon, Jeb ain't even gonna have a job, cause Watson gonna listen to these videos, and they ain't gonna learn how to be funny, and he gonna do it better than Jeb. And even though the Avengers try to stop him, Ultron still run off with that vibranium because the AI be putting the Avengers out of a job too. So the Hulk goes on the rag and starts f***ing up a bunch of shit. And this is the point of the movie where you realize your ass is going kinda numb, and this long fake shitty CGI sequence is probably gonna last at least 5 minutes, and it might be a good time to go take a piss because you've tried to drown your sorrows in Coca-Cola Classic for the past 46 minutes as you question the point of this movie and why you paid $15 for this boring shit and $4.50 for a large Coca-Cola Classic that was mostly iced when you could have waited for this shit to come out on DVD, checked it out from the public library like Jeb did, and bought a whole fucking 2 liter of that sweet caramel physic goodness for $1.50. And could have been $18 to the good. But no, because you a dumb somebody. But hey, at least you get a free refill. You know what? I'm about tired of this. Let's get this shit done and stick a fork in it. The public shits its pants and thinks the Avengers are the bad guys. They all go hiding out at Hawkeye's crib where some of them find out he got a bae, two brats, and a bun in the oven. Ultron goes to Saul and uses the scepter to take over the mind of this scientific bit, and she makes him a body of some fake plastic shit so he can fit in amongst the Hollywood elites. And just when I thought this movie couldn't get worse, let's just call him Stax Edwards. Anyway, Thor goes to find Bootstrap Bill because he needs a little insight into how the world gonna go boom boom. And Nick Fury be like, you blitz all night. You make sure Ultron remember forever the night he fought the Titans. I mean the Avengers. Sorry about that. I segued into a good movie, didn't I? Ultron tries to get into his own pants. I told you he was hot for himself. But the girl twin sees he wants to off all the humans and they are like, oh, we too are humans. So they leave, the Avengers hijack Ultron's new bod, and amongst a bunch of teammate turmoil, Jarvis gets an upgrade. And Thor tells them all that this thing in the head of the Vision is one of six stones that belong on some kind of god fist, a galaxy gauntlet of infinity phalanges that could give any city civilians a new definition of Pound Town. But the Vision won't do that, because he's a sensitive soul and just wants to cuddle. Even though he was birthed by the same stone Ultron came from. Well, that makes sense. So for a little while, it's pretty much a bunch of pew-pews and boom-booms, ad placements and abs, while Ultron has lifted the nameless capital city of Sokovia, whereby he can use a different method to turn that shit and the whole goddamn planet into Pound Town, which ain't gonna be nearly as fun as it sounds. And spoiler alert, the Avengers win! And they all think they look cool, but they don't. They all look like a bunch of Oh, and that one Pedro Quicksliver or whatever dies, and the sister be all sad. So she literally and metaphorically rips out Ultron's heart in an act of revenge or whatever. And the Hulk leaves Natasha on red, and you know how annoying that shit is. And he flies his rotund green ass out of there, leaving Scarlet a sad blueness and a green dickless. And that's pretty much it. I'm pretty sure they'll find a reason to bring the team back together for another movie. That'll come out, this weekend, whoop, there it is. Whoop, shakalaka, shakalaka, the end. You know, as I watched this movie, I envisioned my blood cells passing through my veins looking at each other like this. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe for your regular fix of meth. You can expect me to upload videos the next time more Marvel Kalmanor is available for rental from my local library. For Movies Explained 4, I'm Jeb, a dyer. Oh, my head hurts. I hate everything. Except tag team. Whew, shit.
We got any tequila?